Come in the feeling of this place already tonight. Stand to your feet. Stand to your feet and let's begin to worship. Hallelujah. We worship you tonight, Lord. We bless your name tonight, Jesus.
Yes. My hallelujah belongs Do it now. Sing with me, how great. tonight.
Yes.
I want you to know something. I was scared today because it almost took almost a half of the day before God gave me the word tonight. I went before the Lord this morning and I said, Lord, I don't know what to tell your people. I have a responsibility tonight. And I don't know what to tell the people. Nothing. But he's a faithful God. You read as a leader and as saints of God, you read the scriptures over and over again, and the more you read the word, the more the revelation comes. And the word that he gave me today, I have read this scripture, preached it actually many times, but not how I'm about to preach it tonight, because when he gives you the manna from heaven, it's always fresh. Always fresh. You can preach a scripture 1,000 times and then you get another message that you didn't see was there before. You cannot exhaust the word of God. It's inexhaustible. So I'm going to talk to you what the Lord showed me today. I want to ask you to turn your Bibles to 2 Kings chapter 2. And every time God gives a word, it's always for the hour.
Yes, sir.
Always. And once the word goes forth, God will do his part. Because the Bible says he sent forth his word and they are healed. So once you preach, once the word is declared, once the message goes forth, all of a sudden the breakthroughs begin to come to pass and the deliverance begin to take place and demons begin to tremble.
Amen.
I have read this 1,000 times. I have preached this in many crusades. But tonight, what he has for you, I hope you receive it. Lift your hands. Just say, God, I'm ready to receive it.
I'm ready to receive it.
2 Kings chapter 2. We're going to read. Let me think, huh? How I want to do this. Let's read from verse 1 to 15. I'm reading from the King James. And it reads, and it came to pass when the Lord would take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind, that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. And Elijah said unto Elisha, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord hath sent me to Bethel. And Elisha said unto him, as the Lord liveth and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they went down to Bethel. And the sons of the prophets that were at Bethel came forth to Elisha and said unto him, knowest thou that the Lord will take away thy master from thy head today? And he said, yea, I know it. Hold ye your peace. And Elijah said unto him, Elisha, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord hath sent me to Jericho. And he said, as the Lord liveth and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they went to Jericho. And the sons of the prophets that were at Jericho came to Elisha and said unto him, knowest thou that the Lord will take away thy master from thy head today? And he answered and said, I know it, hold your peace. And Elijah said unto him, tarry, I pray thee here, for the Lord hath sent me to Jordan. And he said, as the Lord liveth and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. And the two of them kept going on. And 50 men of the sons of the prophets went and stood to view afar off, and the two stood by Jordan. And Elijah took his mantle and wrapped it together and smote the waters, and they were divided hither and thither, here and there. So that they, two of them, Elijah and Elisha, went on over to dry ground. And it came to pass, When they were gone over that, Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for thee before I be taken away from thee. Elisha said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. And he said, thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou see me when I am taken from thee, it shall be so unto thee. But if not, it shall not be so. And it came to pass as they still went on and talked, that behold, there appeared a chariot of fire and horses of fire, parted them both asunder. And Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven, and Elisha saw it, and he cried, my father, my father! The chariot of Israel and the horsemen thereof. And he saw him no more, and he took hold of his own clothes and rent them in two pieces. And he took up also the mantle of Elijah that fell from him and went back and stood by the bank. And this is where the verse I want to get to. And he took the mantle of Elijah that fell from him and smote the waters, and he said, where is the Lord God of Elijah? And when also had smitten the waters, they parted hither and thither, and Elisha went over. We are living in a time of desperation for the power of God.
Yes.
And it has become more evident to me being here in Boston that we are now starving for the presence of Jesus Christ. There is no more power of God in the church. There is no more power of God in the school. We have taken him out of our schools.
Yes, come on now.
We have a generation of young people who don't know what it looks like to see the presence of God, the power of God, the revival. There are people who have been in church all their life.
Yes.
And have not been able to witness the presence of God. But God will judge the leaders for such. No more power in the school. America have turned their backs on God. So I said to the Lord, what is the purpose of this message tonight? I've preached this in many crusades in a different format. He says, do you know what is the cry of my people, son? I will tell you. My people are saying to me, in many forms and in many ways, where is the God of Elijah? Oh, it is time that the God of Elijah come back into your life and into the churches again. And I am here to plant the seed in this church and in Boston. That when you walk out of here, you will have the power of Elijah to set the captives free. Elisha,
come on.
Ask such a question. I have some things to tell you what the Lord said to me, because he said right now in my ears, in many different languages, in the church, my people are crying to me, where is the God of power? Where is the God of miracles? Where is the God of breakthrough?
Come on.
We have put him in a box. We stand on platforms and we preach. How dare we stand and preach a watered down gospel? The apostle says, I have not come with persuasive words, but with demonstration of the Holy Ghost. We are ashamed of the gospel because we have no power.
That's right.
Oh, my Lord. He said, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God to salvation. We don't have the power because we're not preaching the gospel anymore. He says, my people, my son, is crying in my ears, Where is the God of Elijah? And I'm writing my message and tears coming out of my eyes. I said, Lord, may I never cry that prayer. May I always know your power.
Yes. Yes.
There are preachers and leaders dying spiritually. There are saints of God coming to church looking because they're thirsty, they are hungry. But yes. God says, blessed are they that hunger and thirst, for you will be filled. Yes. Tonight is your night, for the river of Jordan will fall on you tonight.
Amen.
He said to me, son, do you know why I had to put Elisha in that position? To say, where is the God of Elijah? He was frustrated of what he was seeing. He walked with God and the man of God for years. And remember, Elijah is symbolic of Jesus Christ. And he walks with Jesus and he's working with him. And he's seeing along the way as he moved from glory to glory, from Gilgal to Jericho to Jordan. He has seen that the power of God is not around him anymore.
Jesus.
Elijah asks the question, where is the God of Elijah? Because he was tired of the crowd. Remember, he is among a school of prophets. He is in ministry among leaders, among saints of God every single day. And he is crying, where is the God of Elijah? He was sick and tired of being sick and tired. Sick and tired being in church with no glory. Sick and tired being among leaders that has no power. Sick and tired among preachers that preach all kind of water down messages. Bless me, keep me, all kind of message. And you're going home demon possessed. You're going home bound. You're going home sick. But they want you to sow a seed. The devil is a liar. I have an assignment tonight. Before I leave Boston, I'm here to plant the seed of the power of God. Back here, I'm ready to see Boston in the revival of God. You know what God said to me? He said, you preach this message, and I'm about to spark the seed of the revival in Boston. It's going to happen through this ministry. And through you leaders and those who here have gifts.
Yes.
He was tired of the crowd. Verse 3 says, and the sons of the prophets that were at Bethel came forth to Elisha and said unto him, knowest thou that the Lord will take away thy master from thy head today? And he said, yea, I know, hold your peace. He knew that there were prophets among him. And he was tired of being with them. He was determined to walk with Jesus, Elijah, all the way. He said, I'm not staying here. The Lord tested. He said, stay here. I'm going to Bethel. Oh, no, Lord. Not to the blessing. Why are you willing to give up and let go to go get the power of God in your life? The Lord said to me that Elisha said, God, where is your glory? Where is the God of Elijah? Because he was willing to go all the way.
Yes.
You have to be willing to go all the way for God, not just from tonight, from moving forward.
Yes.
Tonight is your deposit.
Yes.
You have to be willing to give up your friends, your family, and you'll turn your back on you and say, I am going all the way for Jesus Christ. Verse 2 says, and Elijah said unto him, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord has sent me to the fell.
Elisha said, as the Lord liveth, as my soul liveth, I will not leave thee. No matter what it costs you, no matter what your battle is, no matter how your circumstances, don't leave Jesus. Go after him. You gotta want it that bad. Where is the God of Elijah? The Lord said to me, pastors, the reason Elisha said what he said is was because he was tired of the leadership.
Come on now, Jesus.
He said in verse 3, they said unto him, goest thou that the Lord will take away thy master today? He said, I will, hold your peace. In other words, if you have nothing good to say, shut up. If you have nothing good to say, hold your peace. Don't come and tell me, why am I going all the way? And you're on the platform, not seeking God for yourself. If you're not willing to go the extra mile, I'm going around all by myself. Broad is the way to destruction. But now, the leadership in this generation, and I'm exposing it for what it is, has turned their back on the God of glory. It is time we get back on our knees and seek God until revival comes back to America. Yes, until it comes back to the church.
My God.
He was tired of the leadership in Elijah's ministry. Hundreds of prophets in ministry, and none of them have power. Hundreds of prophets in Elijah ministry. Elijah, symbolic of Christ, men and women and saints of God in the ministry of Christ with no power. He was tired of the leadership. You have to be a place where you're sick and tired of leadership that is not willing to go all the way for Christ and find yourself underneath a coffin like the Son of God that is willing to say, I will pay the price of Jesus Christ. When you stand before God, you can't tell God what the apostle of this ministry said, what the evangelist of this crusade said. You are accountable all by yourself. Yes, yes, yes. You stand alone all by yourself.
Yes, yes, yes.
If you have nothing to say, be quiet.
Yes.
Don't come on the platform. Don't be in church. Don't even say gossip. Don't gossip. Don't say, just be quiet. If you have nothing good to say, say nothing.
Yes.
If you have nothing good to say about your friends, say nothing.
Yes.
If you have nothing good to say about your leader, say nothing. Don't pray. Get the glory back. Don't just go murmur and complain of the leader. Be quiet. They were mischievous men. They said, don't you know? Don't you know the man of God is leaving today? Shut up. If you have nothing good but to taunt me and to tell me all this mischievous thing, I don't want to be around you anymore. It showed that the prophet was not his.
My God.
And they were in the ministry.
Jesus.
You are prophets.
My Lord.
Ministers.
My Lord.
Saints of God. None of us is exempt. Preachers, evangelists, apostles, deacons, ushers, worship leaders, intercessors. Whatever you want, category you are in the ministry, be careful not to go without the glory of God.
Yes.
Yes.
My God. My Lord.
They were not his. Because you are significantly and purposefully telling Elisha that your master. They didn't say our master. Just a second. They didn't say our master is leaving today. He said your master. That means that you are in the ministry and not even serving up to God. Your master. said, oh pastor, you've been wrong. That's not biblical. The wheat and the tares were brought together. They don't look alike. But only on that day we will know who is truly Christ. We will know them by their fruits. Don't compromise the glory of God. Do not substitute the glory of God. Get to the place of Elisha that says, where is the God of Elisha? Get desperate for him. And don't be ashamed, because there are people who say, I don't want to hear nothing more church. I don't want to hear nothing more preacher. Oh my God, just pray for their souls, because they don't know. They don't know. But it says, taste and see that the Lord is good. How can we allow them to taste if we don't feed them? How do we allow them to taste if we don't show them the power of God anymore? So they are outside looking at the church and they're mocking us. They say that the church is weak. They say that the church is powerless. But my friend, he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. The same God that delivered Israel out of Egypt is the same God today. The same God that parted the Red Sea is still here today. The same God that healed the leper is still in this house today. He has not changed. The church is not God. It is time we get back to our place. That we will say, no, wherever you go, God, I'll depart in you. I will not let you go. Your master is leaving. Shut up, hold your peace. If you don't belong to him, don't say nothing. Be jealous of God. The fact, he said to me, son, the fact that they said your master is going, it showed that they didn't belong to you. Because they didn't say we, they said your master. How much of us like that today? I am planting the seed. There is a river of soil now. Planting underneath your feet. They were not willing to pay the price. So we can go. Anybody can take this and preach a message.
Come on, man.
Anybody could go to Bible school and preach a message and get all their degrees.
Amen.
But where's the power of God?
Amen.
Show me that you're real.
Amen.
Don't fake it. I am mad when I hear ministers get caught and they have earphones in their ears and talking about this person got healed and you're making God look like a fool. You make yourself look like a fool. Don't pray and pretend that God's power is not real. It's real. Just pay the price.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any of you can heal the sick. Any of you can walk in power if you're willing to pay the price.
Yes, sir.
I am nobody that stands before you. I just made a decision to follow Jesus.
Yes,
any of you can walk on this platform. I am nobody.
Hallelujah.
Verse 7. And the 50 men of the sons of the prophet, they are sons, okay? They are sons of God. Went and stood to view afar off. And the two sisters, they were not willing to go all the way. They stood afar off. 50 men of God. Was away from the presence of Jesus.
Yes.
They were not willing to come close to him. They are far off, the Bible says. They are not his. Do not fall in that category. Because there's no record of scripture that Elijah rebuked them or approved them. Reproved them. That is scary. It means that God will allow you to stay in your state, because the day of judgment
is
not denied, it may be delayed. Elijah didn't say one word, because remember, Elijah was in the presence of Elisha, and Elisha was in the presence of Elijah, and they said it in front of the presence of Elijah. So God was right there listening to them, and he did not do anything, because it was not their time to be judged. But the day is coming, and the judgment of God is coming back to the church. It took me a half a day before I got this word. I had to wait on God.
Thank you, Lord.
I have preached this many times in many forms, but not like this before.
My God.
Where is the God Elijah? Where is it? Where is it? I said to the Father, my generation don't know your power. Who am I to do this? He said, you have to be like Elisha, you have to pay the price. And you have to wake up the generals in the spirit. Wake up the leaders of this generation. Because he is more merciful, willing to forgive. So I said, Lord, how do we get the God of Elijah back?
My God, my God.
Number one,
my Lord.
Guys, you have to go alone.
Amen.
Verse 8. And Elijah, because verse 7 says, the prophet stood afar off. Verse 8 says, and Elijah took his mantle and wrapped it together and smote the waters, and they were divided here and there, so that the two of them went to dry ground. They went alone. You have to go to the place where no one is willing to go. You have to be sick and tired of the nonsense and say, if I have to go do this by myself, I'll go do this by myself. If I have to go to church by myself and you don't want to go, I'm tired asking you to come to church. I'm tired begging you to come to church. I'm tired begging you to come and get your deliverance. If you don't want your deliverance, I'll go get mine by myself. I'll go with him by myself as you stand afar off. Because you will never have that permission again. Because once Elijah and Elijah crossed Jordan, the Bible says the water rose back in place. That means it could not cross. The door is now closed. That day is coming when the door will be closed and you can't enter in no more. Because Jordan is a place of power, is a place to the promised land. They could not enter. Their door was closed. You could only see it from afar.
Yes. Jesus.
You have to go alone. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, you must be willing to ask God for the impossible.
Yes.
That's the second thing the Lord said to me, Elisha did. You need to tell my people tonight. Verse 9, and it came to pass when they were gone over that Elijah said unto them, ask what I will do for thee before I be taken away from thee. And Elisha said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. And he said, thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou see me when I'm taken from thee, it shall be so unto thee. But if not, it shall be not so. It is a hard thing. Are you willing to go on your knees and fast weeks for it? Are you willing to go on your knees and bruise your knees for your sons and your daughters? Are you willing to go on your knees and fast and pray for your breakthrough? Because listen, you can't find it on the pulpit anymore.
Yes, Jesus.
You have to go to him yourself now. Because the God of Elijah is missing. We have now embodied the spirit of Ichabod.
Wow. My God, my God.
The spirit of Ichabod hovering over the church of God. You must be willing to have more
of the Spirit of Christ. He said, let a double portion of your spirit, Elijah, symbolic of Jesus. I want more of your presence, Jesus. I want more of your Holy Spirit. How much are you willing to pay the price to see the God of Elijah back into the church? Today we don't want more of the Spirit. The Holy Spirit said to me while I was talking, you have to understand something. I was not just before the Father. I was before the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Tonight, today, I had an audience with the Godhead.
Yes, yes.
I was before the Trinity, all of them in my room. And the Holy Spirit said to me, they don't want me in the church anymore. Preachers are turning their backs on the Holy Ghost. Now they say speaking in tongues is demonic. Don't let that stop you speaking in tongues. You keep speaking in tongues. That's a deception of the enemy to tell you not to pray. But when you pray the Holy Ghost, every demon gets the Lord. Do not to pray in the Spirit. He is your helper. He is your guider. How could you leave the Spirit? We don't want him more in the church, but the devil is a liar. For the Bible says, it is not by might, it is not by power, it is only by the Holy Ghost. That's when I began to cry. I said, Holy Spirit, I'm sorry on behalf generation, the church, the leaders, myself. Paul says, don't grieve the Holy Ghost. Don't quench the Holy Ghost. No, we don't want that in the church. So now they begin to categorize us.
Yes.
You Pentecostals, too charismatic.
Wow.
You guys too much in the spirit and speaking in tongues. You guys have to come to church and be reserved and conservative. And I'm not saying that it doesn't have a place. And I'm not saying that different cultures doesn't work. I'm saying whatever your style, whatever your methods, whatever your culture, don't leave the Holy Ghost. If you like the conservative, good. If you like the energetic, good.
Yeah.
Whatever you think,
yes,
but don't leave the Spirit of the Lord God out of the church. You must be willing to have more of the Spirit of God. We don't want more of His anointing or power anymore. And if we do, we're not willing to pay the price. The Lord said to me, tell my people, if they want to see the glory of God back in the church, they must be able to see beyond the natural. You see, verse 10 says, thou hast asked Jehoiachin, if thou see me when I'm taken from thee, it shall be unto you.
Yes.
You must have eyes to see, because the chariots is not of this physical realm.
That's right.
You have to be willing to see your vision.
Yes.
See your dream. See yourself delivered. See yourself set free. You got to look beyond the natural of your circumstance. You got to look to the spiritual with the eyes of faith. You must see beyond that what is keeping you back. You have to envision it with the eyes of your heart and your spiritual eyes. Your dreams, your visions, your deliverance, your healing is spiritual. You're looking at your sick body. You're looking at your paralysis. You're looking at your high blood pressure. You're looking at your back pain, and to the natural eyes, it seems impossible. But you got to envision yourself.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You got to envision yourself walking out of that sick bed, walking out of that crippled situation, walking out of your wheelchair. You might see yourself bound. You might see yourself in a situation you can't get up. Envision yourself out of it. Write it. Run with it. Envision it. You live by faith and not by sight. Got to see it. But here's the scary thing. He says, son, some of my people go halfway, close to the end mark to their victory, and then they fell back.
Oh,
I said, no, what? I'm writing, I'm saying, what? He said, read verse 10 again. I said, okay. If thou see what I'm taking from, it shall be unto you. But then it says, but if not, it shall not be so. He has put the ownership on you.
Yes. Yes, sir.
How bad are you willing to see beyond the natural? How bad are you willing to see beyond your circumstance? How bad are you able to see beyond your sickness and your disease? How bad are you willing to see? Then he says, what you're going to do tonight, because I'm going to pray, not just for your breakthrough or your deliverance, but to pray that you walk out here with power.
Yes, 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 yes.
I'm also going to pray for the leaders and the ministers of this ministry, because you are about to walk in the same level of power as the man of God. You can't be down if he's going up. You got to be in the same place with the man of God.
Yes.
He says, tell them, take the mantle. Take the anointing and begin to use it to move every obstacle out of your way. Tell them that. I said, Lord, where is that? He said in verse 14, and he took the mantle of Elijah and he smote the waters. Where is the God of Elijah? And when he has smitten the waters, the Bible says it was parted. You got to take the power. You got to take the anointing.
Yes,
you got to take the money and move every obstacle out of your way. Move every situation out of your way. Now that you have the power, where is the God of Elijah? If those preachers don't want to do that, I'll do it in the name of Jesus. Get up and be healed. In the name, put your hand on the sick. I command the sickness to go. Put your hands on the back of the cross. I command you to go. Put your hand on the back. I command you to go. I command you to go. Move the obstacle. Move the anointing on your life. The anointing is in you. Now no man teach you what you will. You got to take it. He said, send and take your mantle of power. Take the anointing and move the sickness. You got to move your sickness. Don't wait on me. You do it yourself. Oh, I see you just moving. I see them moving now. You got to move. Move. I command you to go. Carry on. I command you to go. Just I command you to go. You put your hand in the ears and you take the mantle of power and you move the waters. Move it! Don't wait for me to lay hands on you. Lay hands on yourself. Jesus Christ. I think it went over your head. I think you're missing it. Do you know how much power you have in the pinky finger? You know how much power in this finger? This finger can move every demon in this finger. There's more power in you than any nuclear warhead in the earth. The Bible says it's dunamis power. You got dunamis power in you. Know who you are in Christ. Take the authority. Take the authority of God on your life. I command your own sickness to heal.
Yes.
Tell them to take the mantle of Elijah. Who's Elijah? Jesus. Take the anointing of Jesus that he gave him. begin to move the waters. It is time we find and hunger for the God of Elijah. Tonight, we're going to take the mantle of power. Stand with me. Tonight, we're going to take the God of Elijah that's in this place. And we're about to move every sickness. Move every disease. Take it with you. Take it with you. Move every sickness and disease. He said, my people are crying for the God of Elijah again.
Thank you, Lord.
And how great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, sing how great. Now let me say something to you young people that's in here. I am a young man. When I was saved, I was 16. But before that, my mom have told me that I was chosen and all that stuff. But the reality of heaven didn't become real to me until I was 16. I'll never forget, I was in a car with a young man named Vincent. I love to tell, I used to tell this story in every crusade when I used to hold a lot of youth crusade in Miami, Florida. And we would pack those school auditoriums with 200-300 young people because they were hungry for God. And there's some of you here, young people, you gotta understand something. Don't be ashamed of the power of God on your life. Don't be ashamed to be a Christian. You're going into school, impact the schools with your presence of God. You're going into a job, impact your jobs with the power of God. You are the generation that will seek Him. I'm in the car with Vincent. We were at FIU in Miami, Florida. And he left his car keys home. So I'm like, how did that work? He said, well, I had my car keys and I gave it to my brother. He went with another friend, so my car keys at home. So, okay, that makes sense. So we drove all the way up to his home location, came all the way back. I came out, I was actually with my car, and he got his keys back. And we were sitting there, and all of a sudden, Vincent began to cry. I mean, he was just crying. I look at Vincent. I was about 21. Vincent was about 19. Okay? And he's crying and he's weeping and he's begging God. And he's like, oh, he's begging. And I looked at him. I said, Vincent, what's wrong? He said, I just want more of God. I just want more of God. But what was shocking to me, while he was begging for more of God, I wasn't praying to God. I was tired. I'm being real, okay? Can I be real with you for a second? And then God said to me something, young people, that has me where I am today. And it will be a key for you. Vincent is crying, and I'm sitting in my wheel, I'm watching this young man weeping before God in my car. And then the Lord said to me, Aaron. And in my mind, I said, yes, Lord? Because I thought I was in trouble because I wasn't praying. I wasn't sensitive to his situation, you know? He said, you have carried your cross. Now it's time for me to nail you on that cross.
Oh, my God.
Vincent is crying for more God. And God is talking to me that I had to not only die on the cross, I had to stay there. And I go home and I'm weeping before God and I say, why would you speak like this to me? He said, because if you come off your cross,
my God,
you will lose my presence. You have to stay on my cross.
Oh God.
I have to name you there every single day. Every day I have to go to Golgotha. Every day I have to go to Gethsemane. I said, why? He says, because there is a young people generation that you have to reach. Young people, it costs me everything to be where I am. But I am not ashamed of Jesus Christ. Don't you be ashamed of Jesus Christ. So lift your hands. Yes, Lord, I'll do it. I'll do it now. Before I pray for the ministers, and I'm going to do three things tonight. I will be praying for your deliverance and stuff, but I have to obey the Lord. I want all the young people to come forward, please. Amen. Because death today. I have friends who died with AIDS. I have friends who died by gang wars, okay? When we were in Trinidad for our last crusade, there was this young man, I can't remember his name, but I remember him when he was a baby, okay? Grew up in the complex that we were. And when we were doing the crusade, they told me, they said somebody just walked up by his head and then boom! Shot them by accident because he was the wrong guy. And he was not even saved, so gone. You don't hold your life in your hands. God holds your life in your hands. Everything you want to do for God, He's going to bless you. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to pray for you that God transform your life. If you're hanging with the wrong crowd, give it up. Don't give your parents headaches, guys. You only have one mom and one dad. And if you have already lost either or, you still have a parent. Okay? You still have a parent. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? I'm going to impart to you the favor of God. That whatever you're doing in school, you're going to succeed. Whatever your needs are, your desires are, you're going to succeed. So how great. Where's my voice coming from?
Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, the sea, how great is our God.
I don't know how much time we have tonight, but I'll do this quickly. When I call you up, you just stand behind them so we can pray for them. Father, I already made a declaration on him on Sunday. I confirm again tonight that this young man will be a leader and not a follower. That he will be a light in his school. And as he's transitioning and he's growing, he is beginning to see the glory of God in his generation. I give him to you and I cover him under the blood. That no harm, no death, no plan of the enemy will touch him. Because he belongs to you. Father, I give him to you. You know the season, the time, and the hour. But let tonight be a seed planted into him. That as I lay my hands on him, blessed Trinity, it will grow forth. That he will begin to feel uncomfortable with the normal things he's doing. Will change. The crowds will change. His lifestyle will change. As I lay my hands on him, that there will be a perfect transformation in your time. And because
you have begun the good work, it will be you, it will be you, will complete that. When he comes out as gold, no man will take the glory but you, in Jesus' mighty name. Jesus. How are you feeling now? I remember you on Wednesday. Is everything good? Maybe bad dreams, anything anymore? Yeah, so the sun sets free. Lord, it has life. God, she has gifts. But I pray for boldness. That she will begin to be used in worship. And as she begins to be used in worship, and the gifts begin to come out of her, boldness comes. Whatever her heart desires to be, she will be. I pray that she will stand for who she is, for righteousness' sake, and let no enemy come to distract her. I give her to you, and I consecrate her in the name of Jesus. I give these young people to you, Holy Ghost! Oh, 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 oh. My God! You gotta go quickly, you gotta go quickly. Stand behind me, stand behind me. Stand behind me. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, bless them in the name of Jesus. I give them to you. Don't fool your hearts, God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I give these gifts to you. They are yours. Sanctify them in the name of Jesus. God, I give them that and carry to you.
Yes.
I pray. A healing bond of Gilead. Yes. On your spirit, so my body. That you will give the Holy Spirit the comfort that they will need throughout the years. But I pray that you make them shine for you. For the enemy have tried to destroy their destiny. But not tonight, I see them. God, I love them with all my heart. They are special kids. And the enemy will not have them, will not have them at all. Consecrate them, feed them. And time to time, even in this moment, you let them know everything is going on. And God, I give them to you, the entrepreneurial spirit. The gifts will come forth, and you will use them for your glory. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. I give them to you. I give this beautiful boy to you. In Jesus. I give them to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Come closer. In the name of Jesus. I give them to you.
Yes.
Now, man, you belong to God. Yes. Look at me. There's a plan of the enemy to take your life. Do I know you? Okay. Someone would take your life with a gun. Do I know you at all? Right. Put your hands towards him back. My God.
My God.
Oh God. My God.
What God says, he brought you here tonight to stop my children.
Come on, tell us to tell us to do it! Oh my God!
Listen to me. They want you dead.
Can I ask you to do me a favor? I gotta pray for you, but I can't pray for God. I can ask you to do a favor. That spirit is not a good spirit to have. Man, put it in the
home. Man don't wear earrings, only women.
Well, let me say this to you. Tonight, the church is going to pray with me. Because we're two or three of you, these are men. One could put 1,000, two could put 10,000. When we do it, the person who is trying to set you up to be dead will turn on their wicked ways.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we cancel the spirit of death. We cancel the spirit of death. Our consecrated to the name of God. We call it the Lord. And we sanctify it.
I pray the hedge of protection from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. Under the power of God, it's okay. It's okay. Bring his name. Bring his number.
God is about to fill your fresh pores. You gotta move quickly. From the top of your head to the soles of your feet, the fire of God. I'm in a cloud, I'm in a cloud, in the name of Jesus. I give it to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
No!
I give it to you now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I give them to you right now. Lord, we enjoy His presence. I pray a special hedge of protection over you now. Open doors. The Lord tell me, I don't know what you're doing or what you're not doing, but get ready for a job, says God.
Oh.
In the name of Jesus, get ready, says God. In the name of Jesus. Did I pray for you yet? Father, in the name of Jesus, I give over to you right now. I just strengthen her.
Yes,
I live. My body is full of healing.
Yes.
I break this paralysis.
Yes,
I have paralysis.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. I bring strength,
yes,
my
strength,
my God, on the top, my God,
my God,
my God, Jesus, mighty name, come on, yes, God, I pray for you on Wednesday, somebody is on the ground.
Fire of the Holy Ghost.
Yes, on Wednesday I prayed for you concerning the ministry. Now I pray for you concerning your people. And dance. Now. This word is a key. Which is an amazing key. Identity to us. How can you be hiding from me? I think you've been hired. I want God to give you all your heart's desire. You've talked with us another concerning your goals. I'm not going to display that. I want to pray, just as I pray for your cousin. I want to pray for you that all of your heart's desire that you want to do will be successful. You understand what I'm saying? You're going to be successful. And when I pray for you, the doors will also be open to you. But when He starts giving you your heart's desire, promise not to turn your back on Him. Can't turn your back on Him. Because with the favor, He's going to protect you. Okay? There's no more time for girlfriends and money. Only for God. Okay? Lift your hands. Father, honor my prayer request right now. I pray for favor on him. I open the doors of favor as your apostle. I open the doors of heaven. I take my office and I declare from this night forward he will begin to walk in the liberty of his dreams and goals, and you will accomplish all that his heart is to do. Restoration with his family will come back. Jesus.
Oh!
Yes!
Baby, come. God, I want to do this one more time. Oh, baby. I just saw I just saw a blanket just right here. That means you are officially covered. So, Father, I give it to you. In Jesus' mighty name, I give it to you. Okay, now your son. Do it now! Yes! Bring him home, Lord!
Yes!
I see it. I command him to come back! Holy Spirit, arrest him!
Yes!
Lord, honor my request. Arrest him. Hear the cry of this mother.
Yes.
I command. Put him out.
In the name of Jesus. Thank you.
And out of you shall flow rivers of living water, says God. For now I'm about to give you eyes that you can see, ears that you can hear, and a tongue that will only speak my word. Speak nothing else but the word of the Lord. God says you are about to now enter into another level of your faith. I don't know you. Who is this? You have this name. Who is this? I know nothing of this name. She's aware that she is a prophetic minister. Oh my. She was ordained in Rhode Island. How long have you been doing ministry for? Yeah, but now the doors are open for you to out of your territory. Says God. Now move into
Father, with your mercy and compassion,
Lord, I stand in my office as your evangelist. You said, ask. I ask you to heal this woman from the top of her head to the sole of her feet. I also said that the Redeemer of the Lord sees her, so I declare wholeness in her body. I declare health in her body. I rebuke that spirit of infirmity from the top of the head to the soul of the feet. And I break the witchcraft. I don't know what's going on with these sinners as a result of witchcraft, but I will break them at night! From the top of the head to the soles of the feet, I command your nervous system to get in alignment. I command your bones to get in alignment by the word of God. I command your spirit, soul, and body to be in alignment to the will of God. And Father, by faith, you said that the prayer of faith will save the sick. So I'm honoring your word as I lay my hands on her, Lord, you lay your hands on her.
Thank you.
how you're feeling right now. And what's strange is like a warm feeling. What do you feel on your body? You feeling that? You feel like that right now? Yeah, because she's like, no! She said, I feel like I'm being healed. Okay, who's come? Oh, that's right, come boys, come gentlemen. You too as well. I'm now 6 foot. Boys, you gotta work tonight. That's our cardio for all the good food that you've been bringing to us. I love every food that you guys have brought for us. Thank you so much. I think this is God telling us we have to do some cardio. In the name of Jesus. Like you, and it's okay, because you know, you have to understand something. We're living in days now where you got fakeness all over. And the Bible does say, test every spirit.
Yes.
So you gotta make sure whoever comes in with me, test the spirit.
Yes.
I come again, test the spirit again.
Yes.
To make sure I remain faithful.
Yes.
To the Lord.
Yes.
Because I can fall every day, let's come on the stage and act like a fool.
Yes.
So make sure you pray every time you're singing that God gives you discerning eyes to make sure I'm real.
Yes.
Yes. Okay? Because I have a responsibility to walk in excellence before God's
name.
Let me tell you, these hands are clean hands.
Yeah.
When I lay hands on you, you can go to sleep at night knowing that these hands have not dabbled in any wicked thing. That God has trusted me to have clean hands to lay on you, because when people lay hands on you, it's an impartation.
Yes, yes.
So be very careful to lay hands on you. Alright? Because you don't want transfer of spirits. But I can give you the assurance tonight that this man of God has clean hands.
Yes.
So pray for me. Pray for me that I remain faithful. Pray for me that I never fail it.
Yes.
I pray for me that I don't fail God's people like this. I know my place and I know the responsibility. Thank you for trusting me tonight.
Praise God.
So Father, in Jesus' name, I bring this marriage as it's rough. I saw the marriage on the train go like this, then it went like this, then it went like this, and you guys have been going on the zigzag. There has been some situations where you had to make certain decisions. But God says He's about to pour a new oil on your marriage. A fresh oil. The Spirit of the Lord.
Give God some praise.
Alright. Father, in the name of Jesus, I give it over to you now. Alright, can I pray for the first lady and the man of God? Stretch your hands towards them. I'm going to need some help. Kevin, can you stand behind them too, please? Mickey, can you stand here too? No, you both stay. Two on one side, two on the other side. Okay? Let me give you guys some help. People that I can trust, you know. And this is a holy moment. Oh, I didn't pray for you. I was looking for you. And this is the guy that puts my mic on. I was looking for my friend who puts my mic on. Thank you for making me sound so good. Now, Father, I give it to you for your
purpose.
Whoa! There's power in him. I give it to you.
There's power.
Jesus Christ. I got a power in him. Father, come on. Let's stretch our hands to the man and woman of God.
Yes.
Try not to cry, because only God knows how much I love them. Father, I pray all of their life's desire,
yes,
they will get.
Yes, Lord.
I ask you for more strength in their bodies, because God, they wear out their bodies
spiritually. Yes, Lord.
They love you so much that they go non-stop for you. Honor their faithfulness.
Yes, Lord.
Honor their ministry.
Yes.
I pray for strength in their bodies.
Yes, Lord.
And I pray that the vision that this man of God and this woman of God have will come to pass.
Yes.
And I will get a report of the good things that the Lord is doing in their ministry. Father, surround them only with people that will share the vision.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit. Okay. And I weed out any person that don't belong here.
Yes.
In this ministry.
Yes.
But that have bad interior motives. We rebuke the spirit of division.
Yes.
And I pray for the spirit of unity.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Break the spirit of division.
Yes.
I break it right now.
Yes.
And unity.
Yes.
That people that come to this ministry and serve in this ministry will have one mind,
yes,
one heart, with a man of the Son of God. And they want to come here to put their vision in the ministry of the man of God. There's one vision,
yes,
and one ministry for this house.
Yes, God.
Yes,
God.
Yes, yes.
And it's true then.
Yes.
As I lay my hands on them, I bring up strength
into
the very
church.
Preaching gift will come out of
us. Yes, sir.
that I will, that I decree his voice will be loose,
yes,
and out of him will flow rivers of water,
yes,
to be a preacher.
Yes.
Is that fair, my Lord?
Yes.
We'll have more of the prophetic anointing on his life.
Yes.
Beyond dreams and visions.
Yes, Lord.
That we begin to prophesy and declare the word of the Lord,
yes,
to the people. God says you have remained faithful.
Yes.
You are now stepping into your next level in God.
Yes.
Tonight, the mantle of power, the God of Elijah,
yes,
is on you.
Yes.
Jesus!
Yes.
Have a good God. Probably there, all of you here are, but I gotta be. I have to do it because I'm also an evangelist. If you're here and you're not saved, the greatest miracle is your soul.
Amen.
God, you can gain the whole world and lose your soul. Don't envy any celebrity. Don't envy any rich person. Your soul is more richer than
they.
So if you are backslidden or you haven't given your life to Christ and you think this is the most opportune time to do so, I would like to welcome you to come forward so I can pray for you. If you're not saved, come as you are. This is what he's
about.
Say after me, say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I ask you to forgive me of all my sins. Wash me with your blood. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. I accept you as Lord of my life. And I am, from this night, your child, and I am born again in Jesus. And once we start the respected parties in the ministry, we will talk with her and address that. Now we're about to close. I'm going to hand over to the man of God. Lift your hands now. Father, I say thank you for this service.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for the word.
Yes.
And may our hearts cry out, where is the God of Elijah?
Yes, Lord.
And we are willing to pay the price to see it.
Yes, yes.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
We thank you for showing up.
Thank you.
For all honor and glory. And all of us people said,
yes.
So may God bless you.